Hi, I'm Jake, a product manager on the Excel team. I love the Copilot function because LLMs have a ton of power, and it's fun to see the powerful and creative things you can build with it. The Copilot function integrates the power of LLMs right into your existing Excel formulas, making it the most convenient way to apply LLMs right to your data. Let's take a look at the Copilot function and its signature. So here you can see the signature is equals Copilot, and then prompt part one, context one, prompt part two, context two. So what does that mean? Each of the prompt parts are text that you are using to create your query. And then context are values you can take directly from the grid. At the end, though, all of them are put together into a single prompt that Copilot will return based on. Let's jump in and try it. So I'm just going to ask Copilot first, give me three animals. So here we are. We can also reference data. So let's try that as well. So I'll ask equals Copilot, describe each animal. And then we'll reference each of those animals. No problem. Here are some nice simple descriptions for dog, cat, and elephant. Let's play with a more exciting example. First off, I love tacos. So I made some reviews for a taco truck, and let's analyze them. Let's dive in and analyze the text of them to better understand what's happening. We only have a handful of reviews here, but this can apply to many, many reviews at once. So this is a good way to understand what's going on. We'll look for sentiments. And then we'll also want to learn about the topics of the different reviews. Now we can just create a simple Copilot function where we ask, evaluate these reviews, referencing the reviews in blue, based on the categories, and then referencing those categories off the top in red. Perfect. So now we see sentiments. We see positive, mixed, and negative sentiments. We're also seeing lots of different topics there available. So we can make this a little prettier. So let's go in and ask for sentiment by either negative, middling, or positive. So now it will give us back simple symbols that'll be a lot easier to read. Looks great. And now we can even analyze them with a quick pivot. So let's use the group by function and we'll reference those results and use the count A function to tally them up. Here we have 3 negative, 2 middling, and 5 positive reviews. So really easy way to analyze those sentiments. But it's a little bit sad. We've got lots of negative reviews. So instead of asking for a mix of positive, mixed, and negative reviews, let's ask for all positive reviews. Perfect. So there we have our reviews. And now everything else calculates as well. Again, these are just functions. They work with all the other functions in Excel. So now we have a bunch of positive reviews. Much better.